Over. Hey, Andy and Jamie, what happened today?
Hey, thanks, Scott. Appreciate it, buddy. Hi, Jamie. How are you?
Doing good, Andy. How are you?
Oh, doing good. Doing good. I'm just, always hoping that the internet with everybody on it at this time nowadays that it makes it through this webinar, especially out here in the country. But it won't be long. I'll be a city folk again, Jamie. So,
Excellent.
yeah, thanks everyone. Whoa, at this pace, it looks like we may set a record crowd today. Lots of people coming through, checking out the software. We're going to dive into it in just a minute, and I'm going to show you some cool stuff today. I think you're going to be impressed if you're not a member. Well, even if you are a subscriber, I think you're going to be impressed if you're not familiar with this feature. It's a very cool feature, and I think it can actually help you be a much better trader. And we're going to talk about that here coming up. But first, let's go over our disclaimer. And once again, thanks you everyone so much for joining us today. I'll be talking about some stocks, some possible entries and exit and things like. One. Barry Einarson is a great moderator and host. I have to give him that host moniker as well because he does a very good job, makes everybody feel welcome, and does a good job keeping the riffraff out. And there's many good traders in there. So if you're a beginner, we get a lot of beginners coming through saying, "Hey, what should I do?" Hey, well, first thing you want to do is get in that room. Get yourself surrounded by a bunch of good traders, and that's where you're going. New webinars. You're attending one right now. They're all in the 5 Eastern time slot. We have them throughout the week, Monday through Thursday. Okay, it's myself, Jamie, or Steve, juggling about 3 of those, paired up in twos. But on Q&A on Wednesday is Dan and Brad. That would be our CEO and our CTO. It's a great place to come to see all the bells and whistles, and also to find out what's coming around the corner with the product. So, great place. And I do want to mention the support webinar. We do this every day. Okay, we get a lot of people coming in here saying, "Oh, are you guys gonna provide anything for us?" Well, we do. We provide tons of tutorials on our YouTube page. We'll give you the links. And also the support webinar. It's an hour every day. This is where you can go and ask your questions. Have any questions, go to the support webinar. All right. Simulated trading, Brokerage Plus product. Okay, it's a really cool interface. We're trying to steer more traders. I can't even count the number of years of experienced traders that we have here at Trade Ideas. Guys, we're trying to help you and steer you toward the simulated trading because we know how important it is. Our Dan, our CEO, was making a point today talking about, what other profession do you go in and just immediately start making money without training? Well, trading is the same way. Okay, I know everybody wants to hurry up, get out there. It's the thrill of the hunt, but really, you need to take your time. You need to spend lots of time trading, finding your niche, and this interface is as good as it's better than it gets out there. It's really, I've used a lot of softwares, and this is really a great tool. You don't need a broker connection required. You do not need a funding account. Okay, there's no extra charge to do this. You don't pay for any more data. It's just all you need is a subscription to Trade Ideas, and we're going to talk about that more here when I get into the content. Here's the agenda for today, guys. We're going to do the market recap as we always do, and then we're going to follow it up. Jamie's going to take over, look at the Holly recap, dice up any trades in there that needs our attention. I think there were a couple. And then I'm going to talk about the buy buttons on the chart and how you can, and I know a few of you probably have seen these before, but like I say, I always get ideas for people who email me and things like this. And I had a guy email me recently saying, "Is this something you guys are not pushing, or I haven't seen anything else on this?" But it's a really good feature, and it can really help you become a good trader. It kind of takes the emotions out of it. So I'm going to go over that, show you how to use it, show you different ways you can use it, and to help you, profit in your trading. And then this is an old top list that I have, just for a way for you to keep your, an easy way to keep your eyes on the stocks that had earnings, either the morning or the night before or the afternoon before. So we'll talk about that here in just a minute, but let me pull this up. And once again, got a great crowd. Let me back out of this, if you will. Hold on. Come on, guys. There you go. And let's pull up the SPY index. Kind of see a little pullback today. I bet a lot of people weren't expecting this with the earnings that we've seen in recently, facing on what's called a spinning top. So it filled this gap right here yesterday, kind of filled this gap right there, and we pulled back from highs, and now we're kind of could be sideways. Who knows? Could pull back down to this moving average to put a little contest this fast line. We'll see what happens. I got to get on the road after this today, and fighters. The Qs, real quickly, it has such a heavy influence by the amps again. I mean, gosh, we're not talking about too much further to high. We'll see what happens.
You were, well, the SPY, the Qs, and the Dow. Hang out the 10-day. We might on what, you know.
That's true. Real All quick, right. Mike. Mike's made a little bit of money using it yesterday. The extreme volume high low pro, one of my favorite alerts. He's referring to this one right here. You guys do have access. And green. There we go.
Screen there. Okay, you should have direct our attention over here to the channel signals. And you can see here, Neo 0.0 also finishing in conservative mode. And the one play that Holly 1.0 did spit out only worked if you pretty much held it all day. That's why it's showing aggressive mode. That trade specifically, I believe, was the, yeah, there we go. Let me just get right here, was the CVM, which, you know, the way that I have my AI set up to trade, things worth mentioning here, it's what I like to call a trade around. All right, finding the aggressive profits or the aggressive losses that ended up less than what we see here in moderate mode or conservative mode. And let's see here, in the next 30 minutes after that exit bar comes down here, breaches that stop, times the stop it once an entry accordingly. You know, advantage of that, that's was back in those days. But the AI is going to go through some of the same on those stop areas, because sometimes they can make for very good entry prices as well. So good, the original buy looks like this one pretty much flatted out too. We got an exact Z, get that little Holly 1.0
for volume and Neo forming over the last since months. A lot of questions piling in here, guys. I'm gonna let Jamie take over so I can get some more content in. I got some good stuff to show you guys. But I think I got them up to that point. Thanks, Jamie. All right, guys. So I had this question from somebody, you know, asking me about, you know, the buy and sell buttons on the charts. You got B and you got S. I was telling our marketing meeting today, I was telling the guys, I said, and gals, I was like, man, we spit out new stuff so often that sometimes you don't need to have any of this, obviously. Let's just say 5,000. I'm going to use a fixed amount here to make it good to cancel. So this, I could change this minute to 1 minute. And swing trade, I use a stop. I just want to build and then have a stop automatically set. And I already have all this. Let's see, my long. Okay, I think you have to cut these on, because once I'm gonna see, because right now this is the one default chart long strategy. Okay, this is how cool this is, guys, and I'm telling you, you want to put this into practice. So many traders get just caught up in price action, just jumping in things because they're moving quickly or whatever, and limit alert in this case already been beaten up. Look what's it's been. So I would take out today's high. I'm thinking it's going to go a price action like we see. So what I want to do is I can just hit my buy button, right? and just come down here. If it takes out this high right here, this is where I'm going to buy it. And there you go. Okay, so you can see what happens here. It automatically, I got an opening order, right, to buy Boeing if it takes out this high, and I already have my risk parameters. I got set 3%. So if I get filled right there, I don't even have to be, if I wanted to, I didn't have to, don't even have to be by my computer. Now I can let this trigger, and I know my risk parameter is set at 3% stop. Very, very powerful, guys. I mean, I really believe that if more people would trade, which is like limit alerts, they could, it would really benefit their trading immensely. And another way, I like to use it even better than this. Let's say, let's pull up Twitter, for example. Okay, Twitter had earnings after the bell. Okay, kind of got beaten up in it, down 8% today. Well, what if this were to come down, and maybe, because let's say, draw a little trend line right here. It's got a nice little trend. And I could probably draw this better. Hold on. There we go. Nice little trend there, right? Pretty much at its 20-day moving average. So this is possibly, you know, I could see this having maybe a few days of sell-off and coming down to this nice little trend and maybe the 20 period moving average. So let's say I want to buy it there, okay? I want to buy on weakness, and so all I do on my daily chart here, I could just hit the buy button, set my chart right where I think this slope is going to be. Let's just put it, not only that, you have a nice little pivot area right here, so I'm just going to put one right there. And unfortunately, this one is basing this. I got to talk to him about that. My stop is being based on today's price, on the current price. So I got to tell the, this is why we use dev versions. I'm on a dev version. This is why we do it. We work out all the bugs. So when it comes back around to you guys, it'll be fixed. That should not be setting the stop order right there, right? This is a buy long. And I don't know why it's doing that, Jamie. I thought we had that one worked out. But anyway,
yes, I did too.
So for right now, yeah. So right now, I would not. I would not use it on pullbacks. I will talk to the dev version, and let me do another one just to make sure. Let's say Facebook comes back down and comes back, fills the gap. Let's say, and you want to buy it right here. Let's do a buy. And I didn't want to do that. Buy and boom. Yeah, it's not working. It's putting it from the today's close. So I need to talk to dev version about that. So sorry about that, guy. It looks like the ones when you put it above are doing just fine, but be careful if you're buying pullbacks. You probably want to just put an alert for now and wait till your alert goes off and then just do it manually, and I will let the dev version know about that. But anyway, it is a good method, guys. It is a good method to use price alerts. Don't just, you know, too many people just buy stocks on a whim just because they see a little volume for whatever reason coming in. The BA example, yeah, it's in there. And I didn't calculate this one. This could be figuring it out on the current price as well. Looks like my stop loss is 2K reduced. Well, let's see, that could be if I'm buying. Let's see, it depends on the shares you're buying. I'm not too so concerned about the money. That's all relative to how much you're buying. If you have a 5,000. Yeah, that's probably not correct there. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get on to, like I said, we just got this new dev diversion a couple of days ago, and it may be that this is acting quirky again. So I will. It might be, you guys try it out. It may be okay in yours, but because it was working with one time, Jamie. I know they got it fixed at one time. I'm not sure why it's not working with this version.
Well, that's why we do it. So,
Yep, this is why we do it. Don't worry. We'll get it fixed before the next version comes out to you. So don't worry about that. But for now, yeah, be careful with them because I got to calculate because it looks like that. Let's see, 140, that should be about a $5, $4 or something like that. Yeah, so it may be based in the stop loss office as well. Oh, and I think probably what was happening, RJ, is the one I was using was a $10,000 entry. It wasn't the 5,000 or 3,000 I did. So I think this is right. It's just calculating the stops wrong for now. All right. So moving on, guys. Don't worry. We'll get this fixed. And when we do, it's a really good tool. All right. I'm going to show you something else that's cool. Just for you guys who you want to track earnings plays. It's always good to track earnings plays because you can get some really good trades by just keeping an eye on the stocks that had recently had earnings. Okay, and this is an earnings watcher. Okay, you can see here earnings date. Without getting too technical about this, you're going to have to trust me on this. Well, here's what I want you to do. I want you to think of like a linear graph, okay, with zero being midnight. And anything to the left is the past. Anything to the right on that graph is the future or today or the future. So what happens on earnings day, let me just show you how you configure this. Very simple. I'm looking for stocks that are over $5. The relative volume has to be at least 2. I want stocks that are trading good volume on their earnings. Average daily volume has to be at least 300,000 shares a day. And earnings date, I have negative 0.25 is the minimum and positive 0.25 as the max. Well, let's click our little show me button. These show me buttons are very handy. You can click on these and it'll tell you. Earnings will be reported no more than 0.25 days after 12 a.m. this morning. So that would be this, they had earnings this morning. Earnings will not be reported no more than 0.25 days before midnight. So that means, it's like I said, you'll have to get used to this, but this means basically that they had earnings after the close yesterday. All right, so, and don't worry, I'll share this with you guys so you can have it. It's, like I said, it's a nifty little thing to have, especially during, well, obviously only during earnings season. So what you can do is you can, you know, you could sort this by, this is in, sort of looks like now by position in your range. But if you want to do in relative volume, see which ones are doing the strongest relative volume today. Okay, you can see it looks like UBSI was in there. Or maybe you can change from the close. You want to see which is up the highest percentage. You know, if you're looking for continued momentum trades, this is might be something that you kind of watch, you know, early in the morning. Stocks that may continue to go. There was a nice little horseshoe this morning on the 15-minute chart on this one. You know, if you're keeping an eye on this, maybe you would have caught that. Another one that kind of gapped up, moved pretty quickly there, but a beautiful one here. Look at this ABMD, you know, up 13%, but boy, look at that take off today. So if you're watching something like this and you're keeping an eye and just scrolling through these things, maybe you can catch, maybe you would watch this, see this range breakout in this AM, you know, BD, if you're watching it, seeing it go sideways and then break. Of course, they had a pretty big tick this morning, but if you just use the body and then nice little breakout from there would have been kind of nice right there. So once again, great little tool just to have up, you know, to keep track of earnings and see which ones are at highs. Position in range. This is another one. You can just have it on position in range. Let's put it back on. I'm going to go back in history now, and we're going to go back to, time frame, and we're going to go back to historical date. I'm on central time, so I'm going to put it at 9 o'clock. That would be 30 minutes after the market opened. Got to make sure you put it on AM, and if you had it sort by position and range, you would see all these stocks, I'm sorry, clicked on it, that are at their highs. Okay, there was VC. Of course, there was another beautiful one right at this. At 9 o'clock, you're seeing this one right here, just flirting around with highs, and it had a nice little move there. This one didn't look it fared too well. Yeah, did for a bit though. Had a nice little pop there if you're a day trader. Got to remember the market we're in too. It was kind of a bearish tape today. So, all right. So a lot of these continuation patterns, they did not continue because of the market that we had. But nonetheless, I am going to share this. I'm going to sort it by, let's just sort it by position and range, and I'll share this with you guys. Oh wait, let me put it back on real time. You don't want a history one. Live during market hours. And save and share to cloud. All right, and I'm gonna drop it into the chat window so you guys will have access to this. Always like to try to bring this up around the thick of earnings season so people will have this and can utilize it. All right, it's in the chat window, so anybody who wants that, just grab that code and hopefully you know how to load it. Just let us know. If you don't, we can help you out there. Jamie, did we have a lot of questions in here? I got some time. I want to save some time for any questions because I know we have a lot of people in here and I want to answer any questions.
Yeah, and I've been knocking them out pretty good. We did have a request for your layout. Okay. Somebody likes your layout there. I'm like, I don't think Andy would mind sharing layout. So if you want to drop that into the chat area, I dropped the cloud link for Hilo Pro in there as well. There were a couple of requests, and I think some people were wanting the Master Blaster as well.
Oh yeah, Master Blaster is a good one. I'll definitely let me share this entire layout right quick, and I'll just name it for you. Andy's layout. Save and share. Copy all. All right, it is in there. And Extreme Master Blaster, yeah, that's a good one. Of course, anybody who just copied my layout right there, it will be in that, so you don't need to copy this as well, but I'm going to share it for those who have their own layout and are quite pleased with it. Extreme MB is what I'll call it. All right, there is Extreme Master Blaster. And just to break down this real quick, basically what it is, guys, you can see the strategy name. I'm looking for stocks that are low floats, extreme volume over $10, extreme volume $2 to $10. I do have some 52-week high stuff in here, and I do have some all-time highs. I don't know if any. Yep, there's one right there.
And THMO today. Real quick, I want to say 10 seconds on our 1 minute chart refreshes, or did we get it down below that? I can't remember.
On what? On our charts?
Yeah.
Our chart 10 data? No, I think we got it below that. I think it's probably closer to, you know, in between 3 and 5 now, but.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I couldn't remember off the top of my head. So yeah, 3 to 5 seconds on the refresh there for Calvin.
Yeah. It's and guys, you gotta understand, we are pumping so much data in with all of our alerts. You know, there's a lot of competition out there that do a lot of scanning. But boy, when you're pumping all these real time alerts through with all the data that comes with it, we have to cut it back somewhere. We will always be an idea generation / AI. Chart is just something we kind of added for your convenience. Many people use their own charting platforms, eSignal, whatever you might use. But so we'll probably add new features. But yeah, I'm not sure, you know, if we're going to like speed it up real fast to get, you know, to be real time like our alerts are. Yes, Joanne, the this will be recorded, okay, and it'll probably be up tomorrow morning sometimes. Okay, you can just look through it, look for it on our YouTube page. I think if you're signed up, you get a link notifying you too. No, we don't do, I don't think we do haiku candles. Is that what they are? Here's what we're limited to right now. We do, we added a Keltner channel. I'm VWAP. Yeah, we got a few indicators. You can see them there. If you want to see them, just right click and go to indicators and you can see what we have. I'm a pretty basic guy. You can see just a couple of moving averages and some volume is all. I don't like to get too caught up in that. Let's see. When the strategy feature will be available in production. Strategy feature.
You didn't know exactly what they were getting.
You have access to build your own strategies for a while now. Let's see. Yeah, like you called it, got most of them. Thanks, Jamie. All right, guys. It looks like does a manual exist for the software? Not a manual per se. We found it easier to give you a visual. That's why we do so many tutorials and videos. If you go to our YouTube channel, go to the playlist. We have short videos. We have numerous short videos in there if you just want to catch something quick. I will show you this, though. If you go to any window and you go to configuration, and let's say you're searching for VWAP. You'll see all the VWAP we have, and let's say you're interested in this VWAP one. Okay, go to that, and we have a help button right here. So all you got to do, and we have something for every one of our alerts and every filter that's in there. So just go to the help button. It's going to take you to a document page. All right, and it will. Pardon me, my internet is getting real slow. But there's your document page, and as I scroll through, you can see we have a definition for everything that we have. So that's your best resource. Once again, just go to the search, highlight something, and click on help. Dong, I can't really do that because we don't have filters for EMAs. Okay. Aris, I just don't have time to build a strategy. If you're looking for like help building a strategy, just send us an email. I'll drop the email in there and we will get back to you with something. I don't have time to, you know, build something for you. Sometimes it takes, you know, we may spend 30 to 45 minutes trying to get you started on something. But if you'll send an email, if you're looking, where did I send that to? Somebody, I must have had somebody else. Let me do it again. info@trade-ideas.com, and we'll get you going. Yes, you can do live screening, Zozo, of pre-market. We have a pre-market channel right here that will have scanners in there, show you all the stocks that are gapping up and gapping down, so you don't even have to build them. We'll have them in there for you in the pre-market channel. All right, looks like all the questions are in. Great attendees today. Thank you so much for all your time. You guys hang on. Scott got some good information coming up to you about a test drive that's going to be happening soon. And also for those that don't want to wait, he'll give you a discount code. So I'll bring Scott back in.
All right, thanks, Andy. Couple items on the way out. We do have a test drive coming up on May 11th. That's coming up soon. Go ahead and reserve your spot at trade-ideas.com/test drive. You get to try out all the premium features for 2 weeks. We're running up from May 11th to May 22nd. So don't sign up late and miss days. Sign up in advance so you get the entire 2 weeks. Going to have a special education time in the live room, and the cost covers all the extra overhead we incur by taking on all these new test drivers. Also want to make sure you have a little skin in the game so you're sure to participate. It's only $8.99 for 2 weeks of all the premium features, and standard subscribers, it's a good chance to try out premium and check out the AIs, the back testing, and the Brokerage Plus connectivity, all that stuff. So don't miss out. trade-ideas.com/test drive. It's one of our most popular events. We do it once per quarter. The next one won't be until late July. We've got daily live classes. So join those. It's at 12 p.m. Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. And you can get to those on our YouTube channel. Just go to trade-ideas.com/live, bookmark that. That lets you ask questions. Just pop in there. It's for an hour every day. Ask your questions, see what's new. You can also check out Barry's Trading Room on that same page, and then go over to the website and join the trading room itself to be able to participate in Barry's room. We have a new ebook about earnings. It's how to use earnings season to your advantage. It's got some great strategies in there you can import using Cloud Links. And it was written by our CIO, Dave Mabe, who created the OddsMaker backtester and Holly the AI, among other parts of our technology. So go ahead and check out what he has for advice for earnings season. We've got a podcast. We release episodes every now and then, trying to do it more often than not. But we have a good one on our last episode that talked about how to get trade ideas on your Mac or any device that's not Windows. We've also got some other good interviews in there that we've released recently, so check those out. You can subscribe by just searching for Trade Ideas Podcast wherever you get your pods and add us as a subscription. Got a code if you decide you want to do an upgrade to premium today or join us as a new subscriber and save 15%. Just use the code SPRINGHOLLY, and that's good until next Thursday. So use it before then if you want. And lets you save 15% off the first month or year of Trade Ideas or your upgrade. And any questions at all, shoot them to info@trade-ideas.com. That goes into our help desk software and gets you the best answer in the fastest way. You can also follow Jamie on Twitter at QuantBot. Steve Gomez is at TodayTrader. We've also got at Trade Ideas, of course. And Trade Ideas Pro is the Facebook handle to like. Again, any questions, shoot us an info@email. Thank you, Jamie. Thank you, Andy. Have a good one.
Yep. Thanks.
All right. Thanks, everybody. Have a great weekend.
Bye.